We stand here at the outfall of a wastewater treatment plant. The treated wastewater is discharged into the natural stream behind us. These treatment plants do a very great job in removing pathogens, sediments, nutrients and other chemicals from the wastewater stream. Nevertheless, these treatment plants cannot remove all of the many thousand synthetic chemicals that are used in our modern society. This has raised concerns about potential negative effects. And it was decided that in order to remove those chemicals better from the waste stream, many of the Swiss treatment plants will receive an additional treatment step for the removal of those micropollutants. What the biological effects of those micropollutants are in the natural stream is difficult to directly assess, because with the micropollutants also microorganisms, sediments or heat is discharged with the treated wastewater. Nevertheless, it has been found that the fish downstream of wastewater treatment plants have a higher physiological burden for detoxification. We have also observed that the biofilm, the periphyton living on stones and hard surfaces in natural streams, lack sensitive species downstream of the wastewater treatment plants. These spatial differences between upstream and downstream have disappeared upon upgrading one of the investigated wastewater treatment plants in Switzerland. But to really disentangle the role of different wastewater components in triggering biological effects, we need to have experimental possibilities to manipulate those wastewater constituents. That's exactly the goal of EcoImpact 2. We cannot do that in natural streams. We need to go to experimental facilities as we have them in our experimental hall at Eawag. Here in the experimental hall, we have all the infrastructure that we need to mimic what stream organisms experience when exposed to different components of treated wastewater.
In these flumes, we mix water from a natural creek just outside the building with treated wastewater. Depending on the channel, the water is treated and mixed differently. In the flumes, the biofilm grows on glass slides. In the river, the biofilm grows on stones. But here on the flumes, we can harvest them and analyze the biofilm in the lab.
After harvesting the biofilm on the glass slides, the next steps follow in the chemical and biological labs. We characterize the biofilm, we quantify its composition, and we also measure some functional traits like the sensitivity towards micropollutants in the treated wastewater. In the first experiment, we mixed Riesbach water with two kinds of treated wastewater, one with microorganisms and one where we have removed the microorganisms with filtration. Our hypothesis was that in both treatments, the same loss of sensitive species towards micropollutants would be observed. However, the results that we have so far indicate that we need to reject this hypothesis, indicating that microorganisms that are released from the wastewater treatment plant play an important role in structuring the biofilm.
In the second experiment, we test this hypothesis by comparing different treatments. Regularly treated wastewater, like it would be discharged to a natural creek, with membrane-filtered wastewater. Membranes retain particulates and microorganisms, bacteria. Granular-activated carbon treatment. Granular-activated carbon adsorbs and thus removes micropollutants. And finally, UV treatment, which kills bacteria but does not remove particulates. The scope is to see which treatment has which effect on the biofilm.
To run such experiments, you need to combine expertise from many different disciplines like engineering, analytical chemistry, biology, or ecotoxicology. You need to have the infrastructure and experimental facilities, and above all, the motivated and dedicated people, scientists, technicians, to run all of these instrumentation. It's a real team effort to carry out such an experiment. And Eawag is a great place for doing that. We have the equipment, we have the people, and we have a long-lasting culture and tradition for highly interdisciplinary project work. By combining all of that expertise, we enhance our scientific understanding on how wastewater, treated wastewater, affects natural streams, and how we further improve the treatment processes such that those treatment plants do an even better job in providing what the society expects them to do, to provide clean water to the natural streams for the health of humans and the environment.